So we all know a new MacBook is in the works, and it will be the first Apple Silicon MacBook. The company has confirmed that the first Apple Silicon powered MacBook will be available by the end of 2020. Well, we have some good news, and we have heard that an A14 MacBook launch event date leak, and I want to share everything about it along with specs and everything we know so far for the Apple Silicon MacBook release date and price. So if you want to hear the latest gaming news, tech news, reviews and comparisons, hit that subscribe button followed by the bell. So back in summer of 2020 at WWDC, what may have been a surprise to you, that you knew it was coming or you might have not, there is new types of MacBooks coming down the line in the pipeline, and they will run on Apple Silicon. That's the name Apple is using for its custom-made ARM-based chips that it will be transitioning over to the next 2 years. At WWDC, Apple revealed a Mac Mini as the first such Mac to have an Apple Silicon chip inside, and it was an Apple A12Z, the same chip as inside an iPad Pro 2020 model. But this Mac Mini is only for developers. But you are no doubt wondering, when is the first consumer Silicon MacBook going to be available for you? Enticed no doubt by the promise of being able to run iOS and iPad apps natively on the new Mac. Apple said that the first MacBook with an Apple Silicon chip would arrive by the end of 2020, and it might seem like that this will be in a MacBook, either to be a 12-inch MacBook or a refresh of the 13-inch MacBook Pro or even a MacBook Air. But before we go on any further, this channel has just hit over 80,000 subscribers, what I'm over the moon about. Now, some of you are aware that when we hit over 50,000 subscribers, I did a little giveaway, and that giveaway was for an iPad 8th generation that you can see here. Well, good news, Jesse Taylor got picked at 75,000 subscribers, and the iPad is on its way to him right now. While I have some more good news, I'm going to be announcing the new giveaway between now and 100,000 subscribers in the next couple of days. And if you want to hear all the information about this, make sure you've subscribed to this channel and hit that bell notification at the same time. So back to the ARM Silicon MacBook. So first off, the first consumer actual model believed to have an Apple Silicon chip inside is the revival of the MacBook 12-inch model that was retired in 2019. Apple leaker Kumeya is claiming that his tweet that the first ARM Mac will be the 12-inch MacBook, suggesting Apple will bring back the MacBook model that was discontinued in summer 2019. We thought for some time that Apple could bring back the 12-inch MacBooks as the first ARM-powered Mac, but we weren't too sure. However, it looks like it is more than likely it will come back. Before jumping into specs and how powerful this new ARM Mac will be with the A14 or the A14X or A14Z chip will be, let's take a look at the price of this MacBook 12-inch Silicon Mac. iHackerTwo has claimed in a tweet that the new Silicon MacBook will only cost $800, but very soon after he deleted this tweet and this information just became a whisper on the web. However, the leaker Kumeya came along and confirmed that the 12-inch MacBook would start at $849 or $799 for students back at the end of August. And this would get you a basic model of the MacBook with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage space. For the actual release date of the MacBook, this is where information did conflict up to recently. It was thought that the MacBook 12-inch would have been announced at the Apple event in September and then released in October, but it wasn't. Then it was recently believed it would be announced at the October iPhone event with the AirPod Mini and the four other iPhone models, and again, we didn't see it then. However, we have had now a leak from John Prosser where he has confirmed that the MacBook Silicon event will happen on November 17th with announcement from Apple on November 10th. John Prosser has been right on the money this year with Apple events, so if he says it's going to happen here, I believe it probably will. I believe that the MacBooks, or the 12-inch MacBook Silicon model, will be released at the end of November officially. My reasoning behind this is that Apple is releasing the iPhone 12 in a very staggered approach this year, with releasing 4 iPhone 12 models from end October, right now, all the way to November the 13th. That paired with the release of the new iPad Air 4, which just come out as well, I think they'll want to release some of these models first before they start rolling out other models as well. A few other leaks out there also believe this is the same idea for the MacBook Silicon release date, and that it could also be November 27th, what just so happens to be Black Friday, but that is another story for another day. Following that initial Silicon MacBook, leaker Min-Chin Ku believes the next Mac to gain an Apple Silicon processor will be the MacBook Pro 13-inch, and this may get a release date before the end of the year. And if you want a bit more information about that, I've made another video on this channel, so do check that out. It is believed the next MacBook after this will be the MacBook Air, and that is looking likely it will come out early next year. After the 13-inch MacBook Pro and the Air receives the Apple processor updates, Ku suggests that the next in line will be the 16-inch MacBook Pro, along with the rumoured 14-inch MacBook Pro as well, in a whole new design. In addition to the new Apple processors, these models will gain a completely new form factor design, according to Ku. Those Macs are unlikely to be updated until 2021 though. Ku also suggests that these new MacBook Pro models won't ship until the late second quarter of 2021 or the third quarter of 2021. If you're wondering where the Mac desktops figure into this lineup, Ku has made no announcements relating to Apple's plans to transition to desktop Macs such as the iMac. With the iMacs expected to be updated soon, it seems likely they will probably retain their Intel processors for now. Apple's confirmed that it intends to launch some Intel iMacs in the next year or so, so I believe this will probably happen as well, with new Big Navi graphics updates inside them. So it seems likely that the iMac won't see the Apple Silicon processors until late 2021 or even 2022. However, for the Mac Mini, we may get an official consumer update in late 2021. Ku is usually very accurate with his leaks. He said back in March 2020, before Apple announced the transition from Intel, that the new ARM Mac bases would arrive before the end of 2020, and as you can see here, that is very likely. So for specs for the 12-inch Silicon MacBook, the leaker Kamea suggests the new MacBook will feature an A14X chip, 8GB or 16GB of RAM, and between 256 to 512GB storage. The most impressive claim though is the battery life of up to 20 hours with an A14 chip inside. Now the speed of that A14X is still to be determined. However, a recent Geekbench 5 of an iPad Air 4 with an A14 chip inside shows that the single core benchmark has a score of 1583 and then a multi-core of 4198. Remember, this is the standard A14 chip, not even the A14X chip that will have probably a few extra cores inside it. Then compare this to, say, a MacBook Pro 13-inch 10th gen Intel processor. This is the top mid-range 13-inch MacBook Pro, not the basic one, and it has a Geekbench 5 score of 1147 for the single core and 4239 for the multi-score. Yes, the multi-score beats the iPad just by a smudge. However, again, I stress, this is the A14 chip, not an A14X chip inside. The A14X chip inside will be far more powerful as it will have more cores. Then just to top this up, I'm just saying this is the 12-inch MacBook, not even a Pro model, and the leaks are showing that this MacBook will cost $850, where the current MacBook Pro with this 10th gen Intel processor inside it costs $1,799. It is looking likely that the A14X is to be amazing, and to be fair, if the 12-inch MacBook Silicon just got an A14 chip inside it, I'd be happy with this, knowing it's just a smudge slower than a 13-inch MacBook Pro mid-high range model, and I'm paying around about $1,000 less for it. For graphics power, currently most consumer Macs with their Intel processors have Intel integrated graphics. Apple told developers at WWDC that Apple Silicon Macs will sport custom Apple GPUs. In a developer support document, Apple advises not to underestimate an integrated Apple GPU, saying, "Don't assume a discrete GPU means better performance. The integrated GPU in Apple processors is optimized for high-performance graphics tasks. At least for consumer Macs, using an Apple integrated GPU would make sense, and it shouldn't be a huge leap for the company. Apple already makes its own GPUs for the iPhone and the iPads, and they are fairly good. Just look at this NBA demo of a 2018 A12X that was showcased." However, when it comes to pro focus Macs, such as those currently using the AMD GPUs, the transition will be more complex. The company may continue to use these high-end graphics processors, especially with big Navi AMD graphics coming along. Alternatively, this may also explain why the iMac and other pro-focused desktops and laptops won't be transitioning to Apple Silicon anytime soon. So, are you excited about the new Silicon 13-inch MacBook Pro line, and will you be getting one after launch? Let me know below what model you plan to buy from the new MacBook range. Well guys, it is time to wrap this up. But of course, if we get any more information on the new MacBook Pros and the other MacBook Silicon line, then we will let you know. Well, it's time to wrap this up. So if you've liked this video, please do remember to press the like button. And of course, to hear the latest gaming news, tech news, reviews and comparisons, please do hit that subscribe button as well, followed by the bell. Until next time guys, see ya.